All this week, Craig Cannon has been introducing you to the 8 Republican candidates for U.S. Senate. Tonight, we introduce you to the final 2, beginning with the name that is likely the most recognized in the race, at least in our area, 3rd District Congressman John Boozman. Craig spoke with him about what he would do to the recently passed health care bill if he's elected to the Senate.
So I think the American people are upset about 2 things. They're upset about the bill itself. It's a bad bill. It's a job killer. The other thing that they're upset is the process. The idea that there for a while, you know, they were going to try and fix it where nobody was going to vote on it, but it became law. All those kind of gimmicks. Yeah. The Nebraska payoff, the Louisiana payoff, all of those kind of things. I had a businessman the other day say, John, you know, if we did those things, you know, at my business, the very least it'd be unethical, yeah. Certainly immoral, but I'd probably wind up in jail.
Yeah.
The American people are sensing that.
Yeah, you could sense that was very going much. On. And real quick, though, is there anything good, now that the bill is law, is there anything good that you would keep if you became the United States Senator for Arkansas? You know, what would you do?
Well, I think what we've got to do is, I really would like to defund the bill, okay? Repeal it and or defund it. In other words, not finance it. But the things that we need to do, and I think it's very, very important, Craig, we need reform in the sense of health care. It shouldn't be that you lose your job, you lose your insurance. Not only do you lose it, but your family loses it. The idea, you know, that you become uninsurable, you know, and can't get insurance. The real problem, though, with health care is the unaffordability of it.
So you predict, odds are, over the next couple of years, this health care bill is not put to rest. It's going to be brought back up and talked about.
No, I think it's very definitely not going to be put to rest. The unintended consequences that we're going to see as time goes by are going to be more and more. Just the idea of the unfunded mandate to the state of Arkansas, we don't really know yet, but because they're being forced to expand Medicaid, you're talking about $100 to $200 million a year. Where's that money going to come from? Well, it's going to come from the taxpayers. And once people figure all these things out, I think they're going to be even more upset than they are now.